name Louis Aziba, came out of the university, but today I found myself in a classic way. I must confess, in the university days we see a lot of faces, but here we see people that are really destined to do what they want to do, not those of us that want to go through desert. I mean, automobile diagnosis and maintenance assistant. My contribution to this department and to the school entirely, the automobile classes are going on very, very well. The classes are going on. Talk of automobile itself. The course is so wide that you just think it's just honorary car, honorary system. No, the course is very wide. To my greatest surprise, we have to go into our own wires in the car system. I was so surprised to see many things that I never thought of. Even my dad never told me that these things are fine in the car, or a friend tell me these things are fine in the car. But being through the classes, being through the practical aspect of it, we have learned a lot. And I'll give an advice to my colleagues. I don't want to say much. Please, wherever you find yourself, wherever classes you are attending, please take it seriously. Because today is pregnant. We don't know what tomorrow will give birth to. You are in a class today, learning. Tomorrow will be an employee where you can employ people, where you can work for people, and people will pay you. So, my honorable, I must say a very big thank you for this opportunity. Like my sister said, she said one thing which she replied. She have been attached to me by God. And so many persons have been attached to her. So also we all sitting here as a student, having a scholarship program, we have been attached to me. So we pray that God will provide those persons that will be attached to us to assist, and people beyond we are attached to them. So we say thank you and God bless you. Thank you.
My name is Ihama
Happy
Life, and I'm a student of NIDT, and I'm under one of the programs called Computer Appreciation. When it comes to the development of the school has done so well when it comes to practical, theory, and so many understandings so far. Like my lecturers will go as far as teaching us all the nitty-gritty that we need to be able to become perfect in our development. When it comes to the practical aspect, like when it comes to the internet, with all the bad how to connect to the internet, and the various methods we go into it. And secondly, in our school here, our laboratories are good, with our wonderful work being done here by our lecturers, and the wonderful support from our rector and our sponsor, Honorable Barrister Sergio Ogun. We, the students of this school, we are so glad to say thank you, sir, for this opportunity that has given to us. Because in my life, I have always wished for one thing, just to become a computer literate. And I've tried so far, but I couldn't graduate. But I know that today, with these few programs that I've been referring to, I have become perfect with them. And when you come about computer appreciation, it talks about the well-being of the computer, which includes the maintenance, the parts, and how to make use of it. If you talk about the qualities of a computer, the computer speed, and it helps to do jobs quickly and manually in the society. When it comes to doing of work and when it comes to calculation, it is very difficult for the human brain to do this work. But rather, when making use of the system, when it comes to Excel, it makes your calculation easier and much more easy for you to do your work perfectly. And when it comes to internet, it's able to connect to people in the nationwide, which includes not just those in Nigeria, but for those in the outside country. The internet is broad, and they call it the international network. And it has helped us so far to organize so many things in our society. A wonderful thank you, sir, for this opportunity.
When you listen to your students and knowing that you are changing life, when you first started, did you think that a day like this will come when these people will stand up and actually speak professionalism and expertise to you?
Well, yeah, I give thanks to God to hear them sound like this. If you love your Moria, I've known him for so many years. that he's sounding like an engineer now, might be impressed. But my joy will be full when they are able to set up, establish, and they are wrong. I appreciate all the nice things they have said, but that I don't gain anything. I don't get anything from that. But the day I see any of them set up and making money, hiring other people, and they are able to feed and take care of their families, that is when I will be satisfied. So I appreciate. Appreciate all the nice things you have said. It's also good to hear you sound very technical and professional. It's all good. But let's take it to the next level. And let me just quickly add, the school can only give you a foundation. But the extra work you have to do, money or no money, I am told by my pastor that if you get to a wall, and you cannot scale that wall, if you talk to the wall and the wall is not parting, say you walk through the wall, how are you going to walk through the wall? You simply say with determination there are no impossibilities. So if by the grace of God, you are going to set up, get your certificate from here. For being ready to work extra. Don't say I have a certificate and people should come and look for me. Nobody will come looking for you. Some might come. But that extra determination and doggedness might just be the extra mile you need to run to hit it. And then when you hit it, people will come and take notes from you. Remember that. People will come to know the secret of your success. But till you are there, nobody cares about you. And let me just quickly add, now I know I have a common background with prof. I'm very proud to announce to you that if you don't belong to the family of the rich, I congratulate you. Because history has it that I think it's on the third or fourth generation or fifth of very rich families become poor. So, but if you are not rich or you have never been rich, I congratulate you. Which means there's an opportunity for you to become very rich. So when you become very rich, is to pray so that your fourth or fifth or sixth generation will not squander the money. But in all honesty, the times I have to wake up to do whatever I have to do to earn a living. If I was from a very successful family, okay, very rich family, I probably would not bother. I would say, let me sleep another 1 hour. And then I wake up and there's no need to go out. Because maybe my father would have provided a car, maybe a driver, then maybe I'll have tons of girlfriends. You know how this work. But knowing that those things are not there for me, and if I don't get up from that bed, to me that I may not eat the whole of that day, I will have to get up. So I'm just saying this to let you know that there is so much to do out there. People are looking for people like you, but people are building every day. People are hiring every day, but they want skill, a particular skill that you possess, that you are going to possess. And when given, now you are given the opportunity, take it and run with it. By the grace of God, we're going to work out something with prof. The next year, the next class we're going to have next year, I think we'll do less of computer appreciation and do more of skill, so to speak. Yeah, computer acquisition is skill, but we're going to do more of, I'm trying to get the word now, handyman or something. You know, what are going to be doing, time, POP, you know, those skills. There's a niche market for it. But most of us have not identified that. When you go to Europe, the owners of such companies are rich and successful, but you don't know them. You see them wear jackets and all that. They get into their car, have a ladder. Some very rich, successful people, you see them go to clean glass houses on the scaffold. He knows what I'm talking about. Then from there, they begin to hire people. But you see them in jackets and hanging things, stuff all over them. You think they are poor people. But you need to see them immediately go to play golf and driving convertibles and all that. So those basic skills we have to pick up here.
so that if anybody wants to build a house, even if it is a skyscraper, you don't need to go looking for Julius Berger or a contractor from Lagos or Abuja. People should be coming from anywhere in the world to tap from here. And also, you don't have to stay here. You can go to Abuja, you'll be the most sought after person. Because we want you to bring the money back to our land and develop this land. We are industrious people. And the world knows that we are industrious. We are tired of seeing lazy young men. We want young men that will go out there and conquer the world and come back to our land. Thank you very much.